dealing with me lately on the subject of witnessing. And I've been wrestling with scriptures that have been put before me, speaking about how we need to share the word of God with other people. And I'm just being obedient to do what God has told me to do. I believe that when the time comes for the church to open back up, that we as Christians need to hit the ground running to tell the whole world about a man named Jesus. God Amen. Has placed all of us on a mission field so that we can testify about who he is. Maybe if you didn't witness for the Lord before the pandemic, well, God has given all of us a second chance to help spread the word. I thank God for the missionaries that we had the other night, Brother and Sister Mount, who blessed us the other two nights on the expectation moment. But what I really enjoyed about them, I enjoyed their simplicity. Because I learned that it don't have to be a whole lot of heavyweight stuff that many preachers try to put together when they preach sermons, and it really just clouds God's message and make it hard for us to hear and understand. But I heard that both of you the other night, and if you're listening tonight, I'm fired up about doing missions and evangelizing in this corner of the world. God has led me this afternoon to the book of Acts. If you would turn there tonight, the book of Acts, chapter number 8. And I began reading tonight at verse number 26. Acts chapter 8. And I began reading at verse number 26. And this is a familiar passage because many of us have read this passage. We know the work of the early church. We know about the first deacons. We know about Stephen being stoned to death. And the Bible lets us know that he looked up to heaven and he saw Christ. And he said, God, he said, Christ, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And we know that Paul was there taking holding everybody's coat, everybody's garment, and we know that the disciples, then the church got scattered, and there were those who were going out of Jerusalem and going all across Palestine at the time, preaching the word of God in different places. We're all familiar with this passage. But in verse number 26, we see tonight, look at verse 26. The Bible says, and the angel of the Lord spoke unto Philip, saying, arise and go toward the south unto the way that goeth down from Jerusalem unto Gaza, which is the desert. In this passage of scripture, we know that when the church got started, there was a problem. And the problem in the early church was that there was some Greek-speaking Jews, and they were complaining about the Hebrew-speaking Jews, and they were saying that the widows were being discriminated against because when it came time for the food to be distributed, there was some animosity. So the disciples asked them to choose seven men who could oversee the problem, and Philip was one of those seven men that was chosen in scripture. Well, Philip, this same Philip that was in the early church is the same Philip that we're talking about tonight in this passage of scripture. Philip, he grew up in the church. The Bible tells us in the chapter, early part of chapter number 8, that Philip began preaching in Samaria, and his preaching was so powerful that there was a sorcerer, a man by the name of Simon, who was just doing all kind of demonic things. The Bible tells us that Philip preached so powerful and so great that Simon was converted. That Simon was eventually he was baptized and he began to follow Philip. And we know that the next time that we hear from Philip, it's in the scripture that we're looking at this evening. The Bible says that Philip was led by an angel to go down a desert road that ran from Jerusalem to Gaza. And we know what angels are. The angels are, they are ministering spirits that God sends to minister to those who will inherit God's salvation. Well, one of God's angels appeared unto Philip and told Philip what he needed to do. Philip didn't know what God's will was for sending him there. All Philip knew was that he needed to obey God. Mm-hmm. And that's the place in our spirit where all of us ought to be striving for. All of us ought to be striving to be able to listen to the Spirit of God, to hear God's Holy Spirit, and to do what God tells us to do. Well, God didn't tell Philip why he was going down to Gaza. All Philip knew was what God said. God said, get up and go. And just like Abraham was told, Philip had to walk by faith. And that's what he did. Philip, he got up not knowing why. He went trusting God to show him what he needed to do. And let me tell somebody who is listening here tonight, and listening here this afternoon, that God would never lead any of us astray. That God does whatever is necessary to guide you, each one of us. God is not limited to any theories or any off-the-cuff beliefs that any of us may have. God has at his disposal all power and all creation to do whatever that God wants to be done. That's why the Bible says, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all of these things shall be added unto you. And when we seek God, that God won't take us the wrong way. Philip was led by God to go down a desert road. Look at verse number 27. He says, and he arose and he went, and behold, a man of Ethiopia, a eunuch, a great authority from the Candace, queen of the Ethiopians, who had the charge of her treasure and had come to Jerusalem for to worship. Look at verse 28. And was returning and sitting in his chariot, read Isaiah the prophet. Philip, look at what Philip found when he was led by this angel to go down this desert road to Jerusalem. The Bible lets us know that he saw a man riding in a chariot who was coming back from Jerusalem. And Philip found this man, and this man was a foreigner. The Bible lets us know that he was an Ethiopian. And the Ethiopia was hundreds of miles from Jerusalem. But this man had been to Jerusalem to take a part of the religious feast. And he had come a long way to participate in worshiping God. The Bible makes it crystal clear that this man was not from Jerusalem. He wasn't a local. That many times that we don't want to be bothered by somebody who is not like we are. We don't want to be around somebody who don't talk like we talk or who don't wear the same clothes that we wear. But God wants us to reach out to everybody, no matter who they are, no matter what nationality, no matter what belief they might have, no matter what side of the track that they grew up on. God wants us to reach everybody. So Philip, he found this man who was not only a foreigner, Ethiopia, Candace. Well, Candace was not her particular name, but Candace was her title. The name Candace was just like Pharaoh or just like a herald. Not only was this man an official, but the Bible tells us also that he was a eunuch. The very eunuch. That he was a person who had sold himself out for wanting to do kingdom work. Philip had found somebody who was a worshiper. And that's why this man had gone to Jerusalem, because he was seeking after the truth and he was seeking after God. But Philip didn't let none of that stop him. That this man was a government official and this man was a eunuch didn't mean anything to Philip. Philip reached out to this man anyway. Everybody got to be reached, my brothers and sisters. No matter who they are, no matter if they are upper level part of society or whether they are lower level part of society, everybody has to be reached for God. The Bible says so. The Bible says that Christ will come back when the world has been evangelized, when the whole world knows about who Christ is, when our Lord comes back. Philip found this man reading the Word of God. Let me just paint a picture here so we'll know what's happening. This Ethiopian official that he was riding along in his chariot, he went to sightseeing. He didn't stop by the side of the road to do some paperwork. He was just reading his Bible. The fact that he was reading his Bible let us know that this man was hungry for the Word of God. That he was reading his Bible because he had been to Jerusalem, and so now his interest had been piqued about the Word of God. He was reading to learn more about what the author of the Bible was saying. And we know who the author was. God is the author. Verse 29 says, "And then the Spirit said unto Philip, Go near and join thyself to this chariot." The Holy Spirit started tugging on Philip and to move for Philip to get a little bit closer to the man. The Holy Spirit knew what this man needed. The Holy Spirit knew that this man needed Christ, and he knows that when we are around certain people, God knows, the Spirit knows what these other people need. The biggest need that most of us have in all of our lives is to be led by the Spirit to witness for God. There have been times in my own life when the Spirit has told me to say something to somebody. And I was hesitant about doing what God told me to do. Either I was fearful about what God said, I was thinking to myself that I was going to mess up and say the wrong thing, I wasn't listening to the Holy Spirit. But how many of you know that I did mess up things because I didn't listen to what the Spirit of God was saying? But the great hour and the great need for this hour is for all of us, my brothers and sisters, to be controlled by the Spirit of God. Look at verse 30. "As Philip ran thither to him and heard him read the prophet Isaiah, and he said, Understandest thou what thou readest? And he said, How can I, except some man should guide me? And he desired Philip that he would come up and sit with him. Plain for the scripture which he read was this, and he was led as a sheep to slaughter, and like a lamb dumb before his shearer, so opened he not his mouth." Verse number 33 says, "In his humiliation, his judgment was taken away, and who shall declare this generation? For his life is taken from the earth." That's 3:34. "And the eunuch answered Philip and said, I pray thee, of whom speaketh the prophet this? Of himself or of some other man?" But look at what Philip did. Philip obeyed the Spirit of God. He ran up to the man, and when he did what the Spirit told him to do, Philip found out that the man had been prepared already to receive him as a witness from the Lord, God Almighty. He heard the man reading the Bible out loud. Well, I remind you that this man was a government official. He doesn't sound like any government official that we know. And when he read the word, Philip got excited. You know how it is when we hear the word of God. Philip got excited. But here's what I've been trying to get to. And this is how we ought to witness for the Lord. The Bible says that Philip started the conversation with the man. Philip didn't wait for the man to say something to him. He didn't wait for the man to ask him about the Lord. He didn't wait for somebody else to tell him, man, you need to witness to him about the Lord. Philip took the lead. Philip initiated the conversation. Philip started the conversation. He asked the man, do you understand what you're reading? The Spirit had led Philip to join the man. The man invited Philip to sit with him. He asked Philip to sit with him in his camp. You see that when we follow the Spirit of God, that God will move us to the right place. God will put people in our path so that we can witness to them. God will put people in the right places so that we can begin to administer and tell them about the goodness of the Lord. That this man was hungry for the word of the Lord. This man, he was hungry, but he wanted to understand what the word said. Look at what he said. He said, how can I understand unless somebody explains it to me? That this man had come hundreds of miles to worship in the temple at Jerusalem. He no doubt had heard the word of God in Jerusalem, and he wanted to know more. So the man was reading the Bible to gain a better understanding, but he had a problem. He didn't understand what he was reading. He didn't understand the most basic truth about what he was reading. He didn't understand that Jesus had already died for them. He didn't know that Jesus had already come and died for the word. He was reading Isaiah chapter 53, verses 7 through 8, where Isaiah was describing Jesus' death. When he said that Jesus was being led like a sheep to the slaughter, Christ gave him life. He didn't open his mouth. He was led away, and they treated him unjustly for the whole world. But the man just didn't understand. He didn't understand the scripture. He didn't understand that Jesus had fulfilled prophecy. And how many of us know people in our world who don't know about Jesus? For this same reason that this unit didn't know. There are people in our city. There are people in our state. There are people in the United States. There are people in the whole world who have never heard about Jesus. The church has not evangelized the world and told everybody about Jesus. We can assume that everybody knows about Jesus, but everybody don't know about Jesus. And it's our responsibility, my brothers and sisters, to tell the world about a man named Jesus. That this man, he didn't understand. He said to Philip, man, tell me, was the prophet, was he talking about himself? Or was he talking about somebody? And he didn't know. His spiritual eyes hadn't been opened to receive the spiritual things that Philip was trying to tell him. And now, many folks in our world today that are the same way, that they don't know what the Bible is saying. They don't know what the meaning of the scriptures are. Their spiritual eyes haven't been opened to receive the things of God. Look at verse number 35. We almost there. The Bible says, and then Philip opened his mouth and began at the same scripture, and he preached unto him Jesus. How do I? Philip was being led by the Holy Spirit. Philip knew that this was the right place in the conversation to tell the man who the prophet was talking about. The prophet wasn't talking about himself. Bible says, then Philip opened his mouth. Philip opened his mouth and started telling the man about Jesus. Philip wasn't scared to speak up about Jesus. It wouldn't matter who this man was. It wouldn't matter where he lived. Philip was full of the Holy Spirit. He wasn't scared of this man, nor was he scared of anybody else. It takes courage, my brother and sister, to stand up and speak about Jesus. The most of us, we grew up in school having to say the Pledge of Allegiance. I don't know about you, but I remember every morning, day after day, that we had to start our day in our class and saying, I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. That sounds familiar to some of us. Our school teacher would lead us, and they would even come across on the PA system, and the whole school would have to recite every day this Pledge of Allegiance to remind us of our national commitment to the flag. We were being reminded every day that it was a privilege for us to enjoy freedom in this America that we live in and to be committed and loyal to this country. Well, my brothers and sisters, in a similar way, Jesus has asked all of us to pledge the allegiance. Jesus has asked all of us to be identified and be associated with him. And in fact, if we claim him as our Lord and our Savior, he has asked us, he wants us to make it known that we're Christians. He wants us to make it known that we are following him. He wants us to be courageous. He invites us to come out of the closet, come out of the closet and go public. He invites us to stop being secret agent Christians and stop being CIA Christians. He wants us to have courage. Philip had courage because Philip was filled with the Holy Spirit. The Bible says that Philip preached unto him Jesus. Philip had already preached to Samaria, to some common folk. He preached to the regular folk. He preached to the folk just like you and I. But now Philip was preaching to a government official. Philip was preaching to somebody who was higher up on the ladder. Philip knew that regardless of who a person was or regardless of where they lived, Philip knew that everybody needed Jesus. We need Jesus. Our families need Jesus. Our neighbors need Jesus. The world needs Jesus. Philip started the same scripture. Verse number 35 says, then Philip opened his mouth and began at the same scripture. Philip started to talk about Jesus to the man where the Bible was already turning to. Philip didn't try to take the man down Roman Road. He didn't try to take the man down James Road. Or he didn't try to take the man down to some other scripture. Philip started to preach to the man right where the man had been reading. Philip knew the Word of God, and when you know the Word of God, you will know that every scripture talks about Jesus. And that's why, my brothers and sisters, we got to study the Word so we will know the Word so that we can rightly divide the Word to be a good witness for God, that we got to have a good knowledge of the Word, that Jesus is the answer. What the world needs is Jesus. We got to tell the world about Jesus. Jesus can save a sin-sick soul. Jesus can save sin-sick bodies. Jesus can save sin-sick minds. And Jesus, he is the one that can wash away all our sins. Our witness ought to be about Jesus. Stimulus checks for the government might get you by when you're in a pinch. But stimulus checks don't save nobody. But Jesus saves. Food bank will fill you up for a little while. But food banks don't save nobody, but Jesus saved. A good alarm system on your home or in your house might tip you off if somebody break in your house, but a good alarm system don't save nobody. but Jesus saved. My brother, so it's our responsibility to tell the world about a man named Jesus. Amen. God bless you tonight. Let us pray tonight. Father God, it's again that we come before your presence, thanking you for your holy word. We ask you tonight, Lord, to hide your word in our heart so that we won't sin against you. We ask you, Lord, to remind us tonight, tomorrow, the next day, next week. Remind us all, Lord, that we ought to be a witness for you, Lord, that we ought to tell somebody about a man named Jesus. We say thank you. We call it done tonight. In Christ Jesus' name we pray. Let every heart say amen, amen, and amen. God bless you tonight.
Jesus.